Hey guys, in this video I'll be doing a review on two of the new Milani baked blushes, and these are the blushes. This one is like a medium blue pink, and then this one is more of a true, like, not hot pink, I would say more of a pink with not as much blue, more red. This is what the two blushes look like. Try something different with my camera too, hopefully. The lighting is better. I have it set in manual mode. Normally I do it in some other, like, aperture mode, I think, something like that, but try something different. So leave me feedback in the comments, let me know how it looks, and I'll try to, you know, adjust my future videos based on your feedback. So I'll zoom in and show you up close what they look like. Also, if you're interested in outfit of the day, here's a preview right here. Just check the information box. I'll have it down below, a link directly to it, everything I'm wearing in the video. So here's what the blushes look like up close. This is the packaging. I'll show you the outside and everything. Give you a feel for what it looks like. That's the front. You can see directly through the glass, which I really like because you can see what the color is without having to open it. If you're digging through your drawer full of blushes like I had, you don't have time to be opening each one to see what it looks like. It has like two little compartments. The top part is the baked blush, and then if you lift it up, it has a mirror, which is really cool. You could touch up if you need to. I don't find myself needing to touch up my blush. My blush just lasts no matter what the brand is. I don't know. It's really weird. But this is the brush that it comes with. I'll probably never use this. It's one of those tiny brushes. It's pretty soft. It really is. But I don't like that type of brush for blush. I like something more fluffy, not as flat like this. But you could definitely keep that to touch up if you want. But I'm just going to close that right back. But this one is Delicioso. It has a Z in there, so it's kind of confusing. Well, C and Z is pretty much the same thing in Spanish. Delicioso Pink. And it's a beautiful pink shade. I'll have swatches of both of these pictures on my blog. Check the information box for a link. I'll try to do cheek swatches as well so you can see what they look like. And that's what it looks like. I would say it's not really a medium bluish pink. It's more of a light to medium bluish pink. Can be a little chalky if you're not careful, so definitely, you know, build up your product. Don't try to put a bunch on at once. This kind of reminds me of Pink Swoon from MAC, which I do not own, and also Dame Blush by MAC. Kind of reminds me that it's a really pretty color. I might use this in a tutorial coming up, so stay tuned for that. The other color is called Bella Rosa. Abella Rosa, if you want to pronounce it like that. But this is what it looks like. And it's more of a, like I said, a reddish pink. Has more red in it and not blue at all. This one's super pigmented. Super suitable for all skin types. And that's that one. Look how pigmented that is. It's really gorgeous. I love that. I don't think I own a blush like that. I mean, I don't have anything that pink and intense. So I definitely look forward to using this one too because it's different. Honestly, I don't think I own anything like this either. Do I? No. It kind of looks like Angelica from NARS. I don't own that, so I'm not 100% sure on that. It's a really pretty color, though. Really, really pretty. I think it might look like Desire from NARS. No, it doesn't. See? Totally different. This one is a little darker. And I would say it's more of a medium tone blue pink. And then that one's lighter. So I wouldn't say that they're close. I thought they were. And that's why it's good to actually compare them and swatch them to make sure that they are. But I'm going to show you two side by side. Again, I'll have pictures of these. Please excuse my nails. I still have not done them. Oh my goodness. But these are the two blushes side by side. Really gorgeous. I would say this one would be suitable for light to medium skin tones. Maybe medium dark with a certain brush with a light hand, just build a color. This color is suitable for all skin types. If you are like of a pale complexion, definitely use something like a fan brush to apply it because you don't want it to be too pink. And then you're going to look like you're really hot, you've been outside for a while, and you dried your skin off and, you know, you have rosy cheeks. That's what it's going to look like. So just build up the color. You could even use like a stippling type brush, maybe not anything this wide, like the 187 by MAC, but you could use something a little smaller like the 131 from MAC and just build up the product if you're lighter. But this will look beautiful on dark skin tones, like really dark skin tones, really pretty. So, like I said, this one would fit pretty much everybody. This one would too, just have to be careful. It can come off a bit ashy. And honestly, it's a little slight ash on the back of my hand right now, so definitely be careful with that. But these two blushes can be found at your local CVS, Walgreens, or Walmart. You can also find them online. I will link a link down below. Go check it out. Don't forget to check an outfit of the day. If you haven't already, a link will be in the information box. You can definitely click that and go to it. At thebeautybowl.com. Swatches of these. I'll try to do some... Whoops! Brush fell out. I'll try to do some cheek swatches as well. I need to get better at that anyway. So, yeah. I will talk to all of you guys in my next video. If you're interested in a tutorial on this look, please let me know. Thumb the video up and let me know in the comments. And I'll try to do one as soon as I can. And I'll talk to all of you guys soon. Thanks for watching.